Hi, my name is Mylon Lefevre, and music is in my blood. I got my first big break when Elvis Presley recorded a song I'd written at 17 years old. That moment changed my life forever. I went from having nothing to having my dreams come true. I toured the world and played with some of the biggest names in music and had more money than I knew what to do with. I finally hit rock bottom when I almost died from a drug overdose, and it became painfully obvious something had to change. Everything did change when I gave my life to Jesus at a Second Chapter of Acts concert in 1980. God instantly delivered me from drugs and totally turned my life around. I began to use my gift of music for the Lord and started a Christian band, Mylon and Broken Heart. It eventually grew to be one of the biggest Christian rock bands in the world at the time. We won several Grammys and Dove Awards, but most importantly, we led over 200,000 kids to Christ. Now, years later, I'm still living for Jesus, and my wife, Christy, and I travel the globe proclaiming God's goodness. I've been from rock bottom to the mountaintop, and I'm going all the way to heaven. So come on and join me on the road to freedom.
Freedom. We are so thrilled that you joined us today, and we're in Big Sur, California.
Yeah.
Boy, the fog has rolled in. It's a little cool, but it is just magnificent.
It is.
It's still so majestic and
yes,
gorgeous out here. The reason why we show you these beautiful places is because God is the creator, and
yes,
His creation testifies of His goodness. So we want you to taste and see that He is good. And that's all He's got planned for your life is good things. That's all He has in store for you is good things. So we want to show you a few of those good things in Big Sur, California, and remind you that the reason why we titled this show On the Road to Freedom is because John 8:31-32, Jesus said, if you will continue in my word, then you truly are my disciples,
yes,
and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. So the more of the truth that's revealed to us, the freer we get. So we are all on that road to freedom as we continue in the word. So we're continuing in the word today, aren't we, honey?
We are, my love. And you know, I like what you said about the creator. In Hollywood, things are being created all over the world that you can see in movies and stuff. But man, this is the greatest show on earth. If you just ride down this coast, there's parts of it, especially right along in here, that motorcycle riders, we call it hog heaven, because it's just a place for laying it in the corners. And sometimes you're at sea level, and sometimes you're at 1,000 feet, and there's no rails. I mean, it's just, you're seeing the beauty of the ocean. Sometimes you're above the clouds, sometimes you're in them, sometimes you're below them. But it's just a beautiful place. And I heard myself saying, this is the greatest show on earth.
Yeah.
Man, nobody does what God does when the sun's going down.
Yeah.
God wants to create something beautiful in you. If you see something on one of these shows that you think is magnificent, remember at one time it was null and void. There was nothing here.
Wow,
it was dark.
Yeah, that's good.
And the Holy Spirit came upon this place, and God spoke light and spoke into being His beautiful creation. And when He starts speaking His word to you, if you receive it, beautiful things are going to happen at your house.
Yeah.
Beautiful things are going to happen in your health, in your marriage, in your relationship with your children, your parents, most of all in your relationship with our Father God and His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. We want to talk to you today about love, true love, the difference in what the world calls love. I mean, you know, I remember reading a magazine one time on an airplane back when they used to put, this has been a long time ago, they used to put free magazines on an airplane. And I was reading this one issue, and it was talking about all the people who fell out of love this year in on TV, you know, Hollywood movies, stars, rock stars. And the Lord immediately spoke to me and said, remember, I'm love.
Yeah.
The Bible says God is love. He said, those people are not falling in out of me. You don't fall out of love. You choose to love or you choose not to. Love is not a feeling. It's a commitment. Those people are just falling in out of bed. It has nothing to do with God. Once you find out that God is love, what is real love? God is love, and love is not an emotion. Because if so, it comes and goes. You get in a better mood some days and you feel better about life, and those are emotions.
Yeah.
But love is a commitment.
Yeah, that's it.
God so loved the world while we were yet sinners, not while anybody was being good or doing right or honoring him in any way. He so loved that he gave his only begotten son, who came and gave his life for us. Lived the word of God in front of us, showed us how to do it, told us what it said, and then died for us, went to hell for us so we wouldn't have to go, rose again, gave us his power so we could do the same thing, shed his love abroad in our hearts. Anybody that receives Jesus, the love of God comes into you, and then you can love others. Christy loves me, not with the love of Christy, with the love of God.
Yes.
Total, complete, awesome, amazing commitment. And here's what God said, who is love. He said, I'll never leave you or forsake you.
Yeah,
baby, I told you this when I asked you to marry me, I'll never leave you or forsake you. So divorce is not a possibility. We don't talk about it. We don't think about it. It never comes up. We're committed.
We're committed.
The end. Once you make that commitment to Jesus, love starts flowing.
Yeah.
Love changes everything. Love never fails. It's impossible. Because love never quits. Love never gives up. So it never fails. It's
never
always
fails.
Victorious.
So good.
Amen.
So good. Amen.
Now, true love, once you understand, I could not love you without learning how to love God. God is love. Once he comes in your body, the Bible says that we're made in the image of God, which means you are, whether you're a Christian or not. God made you in his image, and then he breathed into man his spirit. And until man sinned, which is what happened in the Garden of Eden, messed everything up, until man sinned, man was like God. Man was created to have dominion. In the Garden of Eden, though, something horrible happened. God created this magnificent place. I mean, I was looking at some of this fruit here. In fact, I think I'll eat some. I was looking at some of this fruit. In the Garden of Eden, God created everything man would ever want. The Bible said that he created Adam. He saw that Adam was lonely, so he created Eve as his helpmate. I am Christy's helpmate. Christy is my helpmate.
Yes.
We help each other do and enjoy doing the will of God.
Yeah, that's it.
Once he created Eve, they had it made, man. I mean, they were in dominion. The Bible says that God told them, whatever you name, you see something flying, if you name that a bird, it's a bird.
Right.
If you name that insect an ant, that's what it is. You are the gods of this world. It was perfect in the Garden of Eden. The weather was perfect. The Bible said, they found out, Adam and Eve found out later on they were naked after they sinned. Do you know how perfect the weather has to be for it to be naked? You don't need a shirt. You don't need a coat. You don't need shoes. Man, this place was perfect. It was magnificent. They had everything that you could want to eat. There was fresh food. Everything was done for them. They didn't have to work. God came and hung out with them in the cool the afternoon, the evening. They were loved by each other, and they were loved by God. God said, I only got one rule for you. Don't eat of this one tree. That's mine. There's one tree in the garden. It was like a tithe. He said, that's mine. If you eat out of that one, it will kill you. You will die. And of course, when Satan came along, he said to Eve, no, you won't. In other words, the devil, the father of all lies, Satan, said to Eve, God's a liar. And she believed the devil instead of God. And that's what created sin in the world. And that's when Satan became the god of this world. And all the problems, people hurting each other, lying to each other, stealing from each other, killing each other, wars, everything that you can think of that's horrible, that you detest, was created because of sin. God gets the blame.
Right.
We talked about this before. God gets the blame for everything. I mean, if there's a storm, they call it an act of God. The devil never gets the blame for anything, which is pretty amazing, because he is the thief that comes to steal and kill and destroy, not God. Mm-hmm. God sent Jesus that we would have a better life, abundant life,
abundant.
More than enough life, enough to give it away and still have plenty life. He set man in the garden, and then he blessed and empowered man. One of the first things that God did was he blessed. You can read it in Genesis. He blessed and empowered to prosper Adam and Eve. He breathed his life into Adam. We are made in his image. His life, his wisdom, and his ability, when he breathed his life into us, he gave us a book called the Bible that will tell us how he thinks, what he says, what he does, the way he does it. That's why he sent Jesus, so that you and I would have the life and wisdom and ability of God in us. If you receive Jesus into your heart, then love comes to live in you. The Bible says that your body becomes the temple of the Holy Spirit. In other words, when you invite Jesus to come into your life, he comes by his Spirit. Not physically, obviously, but his Spirit comes, and your body becomes his temple. He lives in you so that he can help you every day, so that he can bless you and empower you and give you his ability.
Well, hey, Team Milan, I just want to remind you about our Church on the Run daily digital devotionals. And those are a scripture or two for the day that we have filmed on location in beautiful places all over the planet, like Yosemite Falls, the Grand Canyon, the mountaintop in Banff, Canada, the beach in Maui, lots of beautiful places. And you can take that scripture for the day and meditate on it. We believe, according to Proverbs, that it will be a right word at the right moment, and it'll be good to you when you hear it. But you know, you don't have to take my word for it. Let me tell you what others are saying about Church on the Run. We got this report from Suzette, and she says, "Thank you for the ministry God has placed you in and for the word you speak. I personally am old in this walk, but found myself in a dark place of no growth. Your short sermons hit home, and I am greatly encouraged." Praise God, Suzette. That's a good report. We also heard from Jake, and he said, "Woohoo!" I like that. I say that all the time. "Woohoo! This was just for me today." Thank you, guys. So check out Church on the Run on our website. We're at Milan.org, and we believe that each day it will be a word in due season for you. Be blessed. We love you.
Things because of love. But if you love God, then he said, Jesus said, if you love me, you'll obey me. That's why we study the Word of God. Here's the deal. Once love comes to live in you, once God comes to live in you, here's what he wants you to start doing. First of all, forgive everybody so that you can love them. And Jesus said it this way. Basically, do you love me enough to love everybody else? If so, there goes bigotry, there goes racism, there goes all the things that causes us to find fault with each other. All of a sudden, love forgives and puts us all back in a place where you can help somebody if they're trying to do things God's way. And that's what the Word of God teaches us. Jesus said, "I am the way, the life, and the truth that lasts forever." There is a way of thinking. There is a way of speaking. Reading the Bible gives you what the Bible calls the mind of Christ, or the wisdom of God. And what he wants to create in your life is so magnificent. If you could see what God has available to you in the future, you would stop everything. You would give up everything. I mean, listen, I was a rock and roll musician. Most of y'all know that. You saw the intro. I just got to tell you that I found something so much better than any of that. Mm. When I met Jesus, when I say I met him, I had known about him when I was a kid, but when I surrendered my will and quit fighting him and trying to get him, you know, I spent the first 35 years of my life trying to talk him into doing my will. Christianity is about God who created me and who loves me, telling me the best way to live. He wants me, if I love him, to love you.
Yes. Amen.
And man, that's why we're doing this show today. This show is not for me. This ain't my job, man. Mm. We are doing this for you, because when you get the mind of Christ, your life's going to get better. And you are going to love, come on, somebody, you are going to love being a Christian is when you grow up in Christ.
Yes.
When you start doing things God's way, he's going to prove to you that he is not just the God or a God, he's your God.
Amen.
And that's a choice. You don't have to be a Christian, you know that? I don't either. I remember how to sin. I could just start raising Hades if I wanted to, but I don't want to. Man, I found something better than anything on the earth.
Amen.
I love being loved. I love my wife loves me and my daughter, and we love each other. And does it mean we're not human? No, it doesn't. I mean, we fuss and, you know, all that kind of stuff when we get tired. But man, we're committed to each other. We're trying our best to help each other to enjoy, not just to get to heaven, but to enjoy the trip.
Yeah,
and that's
yeah.
what God wants to do for you.
Yes, that's
man,
it.
Do you love God enough to love everybody else? If so, we got to stop judging them and finding fault with them, and we got to forgive them. Forgiveness is not optional.
No.
Just like God gave, he so loved that he gave,
that he
also forgave.
Yeah.
He cast my sins into a sea of forgiveness. Not some of them, all of them. The day that I accepted Jesus, the Bible said, he applied the blood of the Lamb, the blood of Jesus that he shed on the cross, to cleanse me from all unrighteousness. That's what he's doing for you right now, if you believe it.
Mm-hmm.
All unrighteousness means when God gets through with that blood being applied to your life, you are the righteousness of God. Hey, baby, would you read for us, please, 1 John 4 and 8?
Yes, and this is in the NIV. It says, whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Now, what I love about this is, for God so loved that he gave. So love always gives.
Yes.
You know, one thing I love about, that I learned from Mylon, is that you can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving.
Amen.
Love, true love, gives.
Yeah.
In fact, you've heard there's a difference between what the world calls love and true love. True love always gives, and true love always asks, what can I do for you?
Yeah.
So every day what Mylon and I are asking each other is, what can I do for you today, honey? That's love. How can I give to be a blessing to you today? That's love. The world's love says, what can you do for me?
Yeah. They fall out of love if you don't do everything they want them to do.
Right.
They go looking for, they divorce you and go find somebody.
Right. I will love you if you do this, this, and this.
Ultimatums.
Right, there's ultimatums. So God's love always gives. That's all he's looking to do for you, is to give to you, to be a blessing to you. In fact, the highest expression of love, we believe, is giving, because God said he so loved that he gave his most precious gift.
Yeah,
So the best, when love gives its best. It's 100%. It's all in. It's all in. It's not 50-50 here. We are 100% all in giving to each other. Now, that's so important, because the world will say love should be 50-50 in a marriage, but it's not. Love should be 100%,
100%. Yeah.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
In the Garden of Eden, as you know, in the beginning, two of Adam and Eve's children, Cain and Abel, one of them killed each other over this issue. God said, bring the tithe to me. One of them brought God something that he didn't want, and the other one brought him his best of his first fruits. Yeah. And God accepted one. He didn't even accept the other. God doesn't need anything. If he doesn't want what you don't want. Mm-hmm. Everything that God does is full of life. There's no death in it. Until man sinned, there was no death on this planet.
Romans 8:39 says, neither height nor depth nor anything else in all creation. Now, this is so good. Will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. So love means we are secure.
Forever.
We are safe.
Eternally.
We are safe in Him. Yes,
hallelujah.
That is so good. In the times we live in, that's so good to know that nothing will ever separate us from His love. And His love conquers all.
Yeah, amen.
So that's the place of safety.
That's why you
amen.
Want His love in you.
Amen.
Once you learn how to live by faith, then walking in the love of God will make it better for everybody around you. It'll make it better for your
that's
family,
right. That's it.
Everybody around you. I just believe that today is the day that you need to make a recommitment to love. I know I did that earlier this morning. Earlier this morning, I told the Lord, I'm so thankful for what you've done in my life, but I know you're God. And the more that I learn about you, the better my life gets. And I know that heaven is better than, as beautiful as this is, heaven is better than this much, much.
Amen.
And it's because I'm going to get to be with love. I'm going to get to be in this place called heaven where love is in control, where everybody loves God and each other.
So
there is another place, though, called hell. And there's going to be no love there. There's not going to be God there. There's not going to be anybody that loves. There's going to be the opposite, the exact opposite, hatred and strife and anger and all the stuff that you don't like, the stuff that hurts you and that sometimes in our sin we've used to hurt each other. So I encourage you today, make a commitment to God, make a commitment to His Son, Jesus. Let me pray for you right quick. Father, I thank you for my brothers and sisters that are listening. Lord, I know there's no accidents in the kingdom, that today, by divine appointment, they were watching this show.
Yes.
So, Father, I just speak love in them and upon them. I ask you to reveal yourself, Jesus, to my precious brothers and sisters. Lord, I ask you to fill the place where they are with your presence and with your loving kindness, with your mercy. Teach them your way. Explain your word to them. Reveal it to them. In Jesus' name we pray. And sir, we'll be very careful to give you all the glory and the honor for it. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. We love you. Stay in the word, and that'll keep you on the road to freedom.
You can either make it yours if you want to. If you've never prayed before, prayer's not something you have to be fancy with. God loves you. All you have to do is talk to Him. If you desire anything from the Lord, it's in His Word. His Spirit watches over His Word and performs it. Hallelujah. This is more of Jesus and less of me. Thank you.
Touch my eyes and let me see.